muscle cramps, tingling in the hands and feet, tiredness, slow thinking, intolerance to cold, and weight gain. This can all be signs that the thyroid gland is not producing enough hormone, which is called hypothyroidism. Today, I will explain why the thyroid stops producing hormones, how you can be diagnosed and treated for this condition. So, let's talk about hypothyroidism today. The thyroid is this gland attached to the trachea. It resembles a butterfly. The thyroid produces three hormones, calcitonin, T3, and T4. Today, I'll talk about triiodothyronine, also known as T3, and tetraiodothyronine, or T4. T3 and T4 exert their effects on almost every cell of our bodies. These two hormones will basically go to all cells of your body and tell them how much energy they need to consume. When the cells are hit by T3 and T4, they work harder, and this causes them to consume more energy. When there is no T3 and T4, the cells are underperforming and slow. When the thyroid is overactive, there is too much T3 and T4, and the person will feel super energetic. We call this hyperthyroidism. There may be serious consequences, for example, bulging or protruding of the eyeballs, like this picture. And you can see the eyelids wide opened and the eyes popping out. The most common thyroid dysfunction is hypothyroidism, when it's not producing enough hormones, T3 and T4. There are other diseases of the thyroid, for example, tumors, benign, or cancers of the thyroid, but I'll not talk about them today. It is estimated that 12% of the world population has some type of thyroid problem. We know that thyroid diseases affect more women than men, and that they become more common with older age. Today, I will focus on hypothyroidism because it is a condition that causes pains, tinglings, and also fatigue for many of my patients who have chronic pain. Hypothyroidism is when the thyroid is underactive and there is low T3 and T4. So, what are the symptoms of hypothyroidism? The person will feel tired, lack of energy, slow thinking, and depressive mood, muscle cramps, joint pain, numbness, carpal tunnel syndrome, tingling in hands and feet. And also very common is intolerance to cold, weight gain, hair loss, dry skin, and mixed edema, which is a kind of peripheral non-pitting edema. There can also be slowing of heart rate. We call this bradycardia. In women, we can see changes in menstrual cycles and reduced libido. What causes hypothyroidism? The most common causes are 1. Hashimoto's thyroiditis, an autoimmune disease that results in inflammation of the thyroid gland. This condition is more common in women than men and often runs in families. 2, a radioactive iodine treatment for hyperthyroidism, or a toxic nodular goiter. 3, congenital hyperthyroidism, that is a person that is born without a thyroid gland, or a poorly functioning one. Surgical removal of the thyroid gland has a treatment for thyroid cancer or hyperthyroidism. How is hypothyroidism diagnosed? We usually make the diagnosis of hypothyroidism by ordering a blood test that measures TSH. TSH is a hormone produced by the brain in the hypophysis or pituitary gland. This tiny gland in the brain releases TSH, or thyroid stimulating hormone. If the thyroid is not producing enough T3 and T4, then the brain will try to increase the production by releasing more TSH. So the TSH is the signal from the brain to the thyroid to produce more T3 and T4. So we usually measure the TSH first. And if the TSH is elevated, then we suspect that the thyroid is not working properly. The normal levels of TSH in the blood will depend on the laboratory and the type of test that they use. So then we confirm the diagnosis by ordering a blood test to measure the free T4 in the blood. You may be asking, why don't we just measure T3 and T4 in the blood instead of measuring the brain hormone called TSH? Well, that's a very good question. That is because sometimes the levels of T4 are normal, but the thyroid is deficient and it needs a higher amount of TSH to keep producing a normal amount of T4 and T3. We call this subclinical hypothyroidism. The thyroid is at risk of failing. In most cases, subclinical hypothyroidism can be monitored without treatment, and sometimes TSH will return to normal on its own without any treatment. How is hypothyroidism treated? Most patients with hypothyroidism need therapy with a thyroid hormone replacement for the rest of their lives. They will need to keep monitoring to ensure that the doses of this replacement is adequate and to maintain the thyroid function tests in the normal range. The treatment is in the form of a tablet of thyroid hormones taken once a day. This hormone pill usually contains T4 hormones and is to be taken on an empty stomach and free from any other medications. This is important so then the other medications do not interfere in the absorption of T4 from the gut. I'd like to thank the Thyroid Foundation of Canada for reviewing the contents of this video. If you're interested, visit the website at www.thyroid.ca. Please don't forget that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that needs medical advice, please talk to your doctor. And if there is a medical emergency, go to the nearest emergency department. Use the comments below to suggest topics for future videos. And below, there is a link to a document that you can download, and it summarizes all the content of this video. If you like this video, give a thumbs up here, turn on the notifications, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. There is a share button here too, and you can send this video to your friends. I have many other videos on this channel, and check here for other topics. You can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.